On June 11th, 2003, my La Patera Elementary School 4th graders here in Santa Barbara and Ms. Esposito's 4th, 5th, and 6th graders from Warner Springs School in San Diego County came together to share with each other the research projects they had conducted in their local communities. The fact that we were 4 hours and over 300 miles apart was not an obstacle. In this conference, students shared the local stories of the research and inquiry in science.
There were 9 of us 4th graders from La Patera at this conference, but our whole class prepared for it.
I'm Karen.
I'm
Anais.
I'm Jennifer.
And I'm Megan.
And for our science fair, we went to the Austin Valverde Foundation.
During the conference, the La Patera students shared their work live using the Elmo digital still camera, which is one way of doing this kind of sharing. Then students from Warner Springs could ask them questions.
Did you get any information off the internet, or did you just get the information out of the people that you visited?
Good question. Answer.
For the Tom Dibley Science Board, we got the map off of the internet because we wanted to have a map on our science board, and we wanted people to see how good he could make maps, and he sketched them really well.
Then, the Warner Springs students shared their presentation with us.
Hi, my name is Justin, and I'm in fifth grade.
Hi, my name is Gareth Speck, and I am in fifth grade.
Hi, my name is Laura Amy, and I am sixth grade.
Oh, we'll be talking about on how we made our environmentality project in class.
Team up and green up.
After Warner Springs presented, it was La Patera's turn to ask them questions.
How many trees were burned in the fire?
More than 1,000, but we really don't know exactly how much over.
We studied a lot of actions of scientists, and we studied our parents, we interviewed our parents, and we did science projects about a lot of things.
Vanessa is telling us all that the work we shared today as scientists, we've been doing for a long time. We want to be able to show you glimpses of our work as scientists from across the year.
Our actions as scientists. We categorized rocks, we made maps, we made oral histories, we interviewed others, we had problems. Last year we studied remedies. We predicted.
We shared ideas and presented. We decided as geologists to invite a local well-known geologist, Tom Dibley, to visit us so that we could learn about geology by interviewing him and writing his oral history as a geologist. He very promptly wrote back on September 19th.
Mr. Cordova, I was never into telling geology to children due to several reasons. One is my severe hearing problem, which makes me unable to hear questions some may ask. The other is from experience of associates. The children seldom pay attention to anything explained to them or do not understand. I doubt if those of fourth grade age would be interested about myself or how I got into geology. Sincerely, Tom Dibley.
We read and examined his letter and had a conversation about where adults get impressions of what children can do. We decided we were not ready to invite him just yet, after all. And we focused our attention on geology and also the study of his life as a geologist from local archived information and my personal knowledge of him as a community member. As always, we started with our family's knowledge of geology.
We went home and interviewed them.
This example is from Karen's reflection on herself as a young geologist, a kind of scientist.
My favorite part about learning about Earth science was classifying the rocks we found. I learned about 3 different kinds of rocks, and almost all fell into one of the 3 different categories. I'll never look at a rock in the same way again.
Karen took notes on the background information about Tom Dibley that we engaged with in order to form questions that we hoped we would eventually be able to ask him.
His mother's name was Anita Araña Dibley. Was his mother Mexican? Did your mom speak any Spanish?
After we did our homework, we revisited that original letter Tom Dibley had written us. Each of us read his letter and underlined pieces that we would respond to now that we had developed more knowledge of geology and his life. We wrote letters to him that included our alternative perspectives on what we could do as young geologists, as well as making him feel comfortable regarding his hearing disability.
Dear Mr. Dibley, I think when you meet our class, you will change your mind, because we are in a higher level of geology. Sincerely, Vanessa Lua.
Dear Mr. Tom Dibley, I politely disagree with your belief that you doubt if those of fourth grade age children would be interested about myself or how I got into geology. I am very interested in learning more about geology and your career. Sincerely, Michael Southfold.
Dear Mr. Cordova, I received your letters. It is surprising that you or they are interested in geology at such an early age, as indicated from their questions. I can manage to give an interview with them and you. It might be kind of an interesting experience. Sincerely, Tom Dibley.
Maps show contours.
You know what contour is for the contour drawings?
Wait, did he draw that?
Oh, dang! That's good.
They're impressed that you drew these.
Have you ever gotten, like, poison oak on one of these trips?
I got some on my ankle, my wrist, not bad.
What kind of books did you read about geology when you're in college?
Geology textbooks. About rocks, talking about rocks and how they're formed and laid down and how mountains were formed.
After the oral history interview, each student took their notes and reconstructed a mini oral history of Tom Dibley's life. Then, Lizzie and Kari took every student's mini oral history, highlighted it for themes that emerged in the writing. They extracted these themes in order to create a more comprehensive oral history that is a composite of everyone's work. We constructed a book in Spanish and English that told the oral history of Tom Dibley and his work as a geologist. We will be archiving his oral history as well as the composite. We're also presenting Tom with a copy and also to his foundation.
I was born on October 11, 1911, and I am the oldest of four children. I am the oldest living baby that was born at St. Francis Hospital. I am named after my father, Thomas W. Dibley, Sr., and my mom's name was Anita Oreña. Today, when I go into the field, I take my own maps that I have made to learn where things are. I also make the sketches and still make maps from them later. Scientists have different points of view and have to use evidence. If you have evidence and can show it, people believe you.
This oral history was a culmination of the work students had done in the study of geology. It informed us and led into our subsequent study of life science. We learned a lot by interacting with Tom Dibley's lived experiences as a community member. We then went into the larger community of Santa Barbara in order to interact with three community resources. This board was one of the five poster presentations student created for their school science project. Looking back to how we got here.
Some of us went to the Botanic Gardens. We interviewed the senior botanist at the gardens. We also interviewed and interacted with Sally Isaacson, the assistant education director. She took us on a tour. Others went to La Paloma Ranch. We interviewed Elizabeth about her, the ranch's history, and her knowledge of plants.
This I'm not absolutely sure of either, but I think it's called chaparral pea. Because you can tell by the blossom that it's like a piece that we eat.
Do you know Spanish for
him? I'm pretty sure that's what that's called.
We also took a tour of the ranch. David, one of my classmates, was doing the videotaping.
Demonstrating how this was used? ¿Cómo? En un momento. Es que estamos...
This is how you do the thing, how they would grind stuff up and go.
So, Gustavo, ¿quieres sentarte tú aquí en este para mostrar cómo se usaba para tomar una foto?
Moisture, because usually it doesn't grow where...
A third group went to the Austin Valverde Foundation where we interviewed the groundskeepers, Enrique and Jose, and Gail Jansen, the director. Jose's grandfather, father, and he all worked at Valverde, and they know a lot about the history and the plants there.
Thank you.
None of us will make that. None of us will get that. The men who did this place also, one of the things that they did was that they went off to war in World War II.
This brought us to the research conference with Warner Springs, and an opportunity to talk with our new friends about what it was like to share what we learned about our communities. It was also exciting to share what we did with what we learned with students and teachers in faraway places, even though we were nervous at the beginning.
Well, for me, I got a little nervous at first, but once we got started, I felt more comfortable.
It also showed the way we learned.
Last year with Mr. Cordova, we did some interviewing, and we also did interviewing this year.
And how did that help you in any way this year?
We all agreed that next year we would start talking with each other at the beginning and develop this relationship across the year.
So the preparation over long periods of time really does help. Like Ms. Esposito was saying, had we started preparing to do these kinds of things with each other at the beginning of the school year, it would make a big difference to right now. Just like what you were saying, like working together for 2 years makes a big difference.
It felt like you guys were just like in the other classroom because we could have heard you and saw you at the same time. So it didn't seem like you guys were miles away.
If you change your mind, I'm the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on